Alleluia, alleluia. Let us rejoice and be glad in alleluia, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who raised up the priest Saint John Bosco as a father and teacher of the young, grant, we pray, that aflame with the same fire of love, we may seek out souls and serve you alone. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. King David said to Joab and the leaders of the army who were with him, "Tour all the tribes in Israel, from Dan to Beersheba, and register the people, that I may know their number." Joab then reported to the king the number of people registered. In Israel, 800,000 men fit for military services. In Judah, 500,000. Afterward, however, David regretted having numbered the people and said to the Lord, "I have sinned grievously in what I have done. But now, Lord, forgive the guilt of your servant, for I have been very foolish." When David rose in the morning, the Lord had spoken to the prophet God, David's seer, saying, "Go and say to David, this is what the Lord says. I offer you three alternatives. Choose one of them, and I will inflict it on you." God then went to David to inform him. He asked, "Do you want a 3 years famine to come upon your land, or to flee from your enemy 3 months while he pursues you, or to have a 3 days pestilence in your land?" Now consider and decide what I must reply to him who sent me. David answered God, I am in very serious difficulty. Let us fall by the hand of God, for he is most merciful. But let me not fall by the hand of man. Thus David chose the pestilence. Now it was the time of the wheat harvest, when the plague brought out among the people. The Lord then sent a pestilence over Israel from morning until the time appointed, and 70,000 of the people from Dan to Beersheba died. But when the angel stretched forth the hand toward Jerusalem to destroy it, the Lord regretted the calamity and said to the angel causing the destruction among the people, enough now, stay your hand. The angel of the Lord was then standing at the threshing floor of Arona, the Jebusite. When David saw the angel who was striking the people, he said to the Lord, it is I who have sinned. It is I, the shepherd, who have done wrong. But these are sheep, what have they done? Punish me and my kindred. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Lord, forgive the wrong I have done.
Lord, forgive the wrong I have done. Blessed is he whose fault is taken away, whose sin is covered. Blessed the man whom the Lord imputes not guilt, in whose spirit there is no guilt.
Lord, forgive the wrong I have done.
Then I acknowledge my sin to you. My guilt I covered not. I said, I confess my faults to the Lord, and you took away the guilt of my sin.
Lord, forgive the wrong I have done.
For this shall every faithful man pray to you in time of stress. Though deep waters overflow, they shall not reach him.
Lord, forgive the wrong I have done.
You are my shelter. From distress you will preserve me. With glad cries of freedom, you will ring me round.
Lord, forgive the wrong I have done. Please all stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus departed from there and came to his native place accompanied by his disciples. When the Sabbath came, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were astonished. They said, "Where did this man get all of this? What kind of wisdom has been given him? What mighty deeds are wrought by his hands? Is he not the carpenter, the son of Mary, and the brother of James and Joseph, and Judas and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Jesus said to them, "A prophet is not without honor except in his native place and among his own kin and in his house. So he was not able to perform any mighty deed there apart from curing a few sick people by laying his hands on them. He was amazed at their lack of faith. Beloved brothers and sisters, this is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. And welcome to the National Shrine of Saint Padre Pio. Sa akin pong ministry bilang pare, I happen to meet and encounter a lay minister na mayroong very, I would say, very unique background ng kanyang buhay before being a lay minister. Kasi ito pong lay minister na to ay bago siya maging lay minister, siya ay nakulong. At kung yung maalaala, he was one of those na napasama dun sa very controversial na Operation Tukhang, illegal drugs. Because of that, he was sent to prison for, hindi ko alam kung ilang taon. Kaya lamang, nung makalabas siya mula sa kulungan, yun na. Nagsimula yung kanyang pagbabago and he offered his life by serving the church as a lay minister. Kaya lamang, nung siya'y nagpapatuloy na sa kanyang paglilingkod as part of his pagbabagong buhay, of course, hindi siya nakaligtas sa mga criticisms na mga sinasabi, na mga typical na sinasabi ng tao na bakit nandyan yan? Sino ba yung nasa altar na yan? And he came to the point na he would want to give up na yung kanyang paglilingkod sa simbahan. Kaya lamang, sa kanya ko din naman narinig, sabi niya, Father, hindi po ako titigil. Dahil una, ito'y pangako ko sa Diyos na ako'y magbabagong buhay. At ikalawa, at ang mas mahalaga, si Lord naman talaga ang pinaglilingkuran ko. Kaya, sabi niya, ano man po yung mga criticisms na naririnig ko, I would just take it as a positive challenge para mas lalo kong maibigay yung aking sarili sa paglilingkod. And true enough, hanggang ngayon, until now, he is still serving in one of our churches as a lay minister. Mga kapatid, ito yung katotohanan ng buhay natin. Hindi lamang naman siya eh. Ito yung katotohanan natin bilang mga Kristiyano na dumanas ng criticisms or sa Tagalog ay yung pag-uusig mula sa ibang tao. Inasmuch as we want to change our lives, to do what is good, hindi tayo makakaligtas sa mga puna at mga paninira ng ibang tao. Sapagkat hindi nila kikilalanin yung mga mabubuting bagay na ginagawa natin at pilit hahanapin o pilit nilang hinahanapan ng butas yung ating pagkatao upang mayroon silang maipintas sa atin. Katulad nung nangyari sa ating ebanghelyo sa karanasan ng ating Panginoong Hesus, na mismong mga kababayan niya from his town, sila pa yung hindi tumanggap sa kanya, bagkus ay marami pang sinabi. Ganito ang nangyari sa lahat ng nagsikap at nagsisikap sundin ang kalooban ng Diyos. Kaya nga mga kapatid, kung nais nating sundin ang halimbawa ng ating Panginoon at sundin yung halimbawa ng mga naglilingkod na kahit anuman ang mga pagsubok ay palagi nandyan, ay dapat tayong maging handa at humarap sa mga pagsubok na katulad nito. And ngayong araw, today we commemorate the Feast of Saint John Bosco. Isang saint, isang santo, actually siya po isang pari na he devoted his apostolate, his time, para sa mga pagtuturo sa mga kabataan. Especially yung mga orphans, yung mga walang matirhan, kanyang kinupupkop ito mga kabataan ito. Kaya lamang, ganun din, kahit maganda yung kanyang hangarin, Saint John Bosco was not free from yung mga sinasabi nating mga pagsubok sa kanyang paglilingkod. And actually, may isang pagkakataon sa kanyang buhay na
sa kanilang lugar, inireklamo sila. Habang tinuturuan niya yung mga bata, inireklamo siya nung kanyang mga kababayan. At pinag-isipan pa na sila ay, ang ginagawa daw nila ay laban sa gobyerno nung panahong yun. But, katulad ng ginawa ng ating Panginoong Jesus, hindi ito naging dahilan para kay St. John Bosco na tumigil sa kanyang apostolado. He took it as a challenge para mas lalo pang madaming kabataan ang kanyang maturuan, mas lalong madami pang mga kabataan ang kanyang madala sa ating Panginoong Jesus. Kaya nga sa ganitong diwa, mga kapatid, dalawang magandang ugali yung magandang taglay natin sa mga ganitong karanasan sa ating buhay. The number one attitude is this: in the midst of opposition, let us continue doing good. Sa gitna ng maraming mga oppositions minsan sa ating pagpipilit na maging sumunod sa ating Panginoong Jesus, huwag tayong titigil sa paggawa ng mabuti. Meron nga kasabihan ang sabi po ay ganito, mas piliin daw nating maging mabuti kaysa maging masaya. Bakit? Kasi minsan yung mga bagay na nagpapasaya sa atin, yun yung mga bagay na minsan naglalayo sa ating Diyos. Yun yung mga bagay na pinapahalagahan ng mundo. Whereas, kung yung pagpapakabuti, although ang paggawa ng kabutihan, minsan it would always entail sacrifice, sigurado naman tayo. Tayo'y dadalhin ito sa kaligtasan sa ating Panginoong Jesus. Hindi tayo dapat panghinaan ng loob kapag may mga criticisms o may mga pagsubok tayong kinakaharap. Sa pagkatandaan po natin, ang mahalaga ay maging tapat tayo sa ating tungkulin sa Diyos, or rather sa Diyos mismo, dahil sa Kanya lamang tayo magsusulit balang araw. Lahat naman tayo sa Kanya naglilingkod eh. And at the end of our life, sa Kanya tayo magsusulit ng ating buhay. Sabi nga ni Saint Therese, o ni Mother Teresa of Calcutta, we are called not to be successful, rather, we are called to be faithful. That's the number one attitude na meron dapat tayo. In the midst of opposition, let us continue doing good. The second attitude is this. Ito yung mababasa po natin sa Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 5, verse 44. Ano yung sabi doon? Pray for those who persecute you. Pray for those who persecute you. Kaya naman, ito ang makakristyanong tugon sa mga taong tinutulog sa atin ni usig ang mga bagay na ginagawa at pilit tayong pinipintasan. At sa katunayan, ang karanasang ito ay pakikibahagi natin sa hirap ng ating Panginoong Jesus na kapag inialay natin ay maaring pakinabangan tungo sa patuloy na paglago ng pananampalataya. Hindi lamang ng pananampalataya natin, kundi pananampalataya ng simbahan. Mga kapatid, trials are always inevitable. Andyan lang yan. Sa pagsisikap nating gumawa ng mabuti, laging may opposition, laging may kontra, laging may pagsubok. Pero maliwanag ang mensahe ng Ebanghelyo, maliwanag din ang mensahe ng buhay ni San Juan Bosco. Sa kabila ng lahat ng ito, patuloy tayong sumunod sa ating Panginoong Jesus, patuloy tayong gumawa ng mabuti sa kabila ng maraming pagsubok na kinakaharap natin. Sapagkat nakasisiguro tayo, kaligtasan ang ating maging gantimpala sa pagsisikap natin sa paggawa ng mga ito. Pagpalain po tayo ng Diyos ngayon at magpakailanman.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets.
Receive your forgiveness, O Lord.
to you. All this gift we offer for your glory.
Let us all stand.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May the oblation made by your consecrated people in commemoration of Saint John Bosco be acceptable to you, we pray, O Lord. And grant that by participation in this mystery, we may reflect the pattern of your love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For us on the festival of Saint John Bosco, you bid your church rejoice. So to you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna.
Unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gilbert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John Bosco, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Let us all stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Those who cannot kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep
us safe
for eternal life.
Collection which will be done is for the continuing development of the parish and national shrine of Saint Father Pio and for the needs and welfare of the sick and retired priest of the Archdiocese of Lipa. Thank you for your offering.
Let us all stand.
the rest of my days.
Let us pray. May partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast day of St. John Bosco, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer for intercession to Santo Padre Pio. All together, Padre Pio, Holy Monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon in this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage, with you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that you concede, bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain, in God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the Most Holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please be seated for some announcements. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa Pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ng inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, mga kapiyo, kami po'y humihingi na inyong kaunting oras at pakikiisa para sa pagsusulat ng inyong mga pangalan at ilang detalye sa ating Pilgrims Information Record Books na makikita sa paligid ng ating mga simbahan. Ito po ay bahagi ng documentation program para sa pagpapalawig ng mga datos at turismong pangsimbahan at bilang alaala din ng inyong pagbisita sa Pambansang Dambana. Para po sa ating mga balikbayan, OFW at mga kasama niyong foreigners, doon po kayo magsusulat sa International Pilgrims Record Book. Gagabayan po kayo ng ating mga tagapaglingkod. Ika-apat, ngayong Sabado, 3 ng Pebrero, ay unang Sabado ng buwan. Mayroon po tayong prosesyon sa karangalan ng Mahal na Birhen sa ganap na 5 ng umaga na sisimula natin sa may harap ng Fountain of Hope. Ang mga sasama ay inaanyayahang magdala ng kandila. Maraming salamat po at mangyaring panatilihin natin ang kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating mga simbahan. Magsitayo na po ang lahat para sa pagbabasbas ng religious articles.
Mga kapatid, manalangin tayo sa Diyos Amang makapangyarihan upang tayo ay maging kawangis ni Kristo sa taimtim na pagdalangin sa tulong ng mga larawan at mga dasalan. O Panginoong Diyos, Ikaw ang bukal ng lahat ng pagpapala at biyaya. Ibuhos mo po ang iyong bendisyon sa mga gamit na ito sa pananalangin na nagpapaalaala ng iyong kabutihan, kabanalan at pagmamahal sa amin. Upang ang lahat na dumulog at magdasal gamit ang mga ito ay magtamo ng iyong awa at biyaya. Loobin mong tularan nila ang kabanalan at aral ng Panginoon at ng mga santo magpasawalang hanggan.
Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord. Proclaim His name. Proclaim His name. Give thanks to the Lord.